sales of the records because that particular company was pretty fair with me. But I met Elvis at American Music in Los Angeles. He was sitting down in a little restaurant next door, and I walked in there. I said, "Oh, you're the one." He said, "What did I do?" I said, "It's not what you did, it's what you didn't do." I said, "You took bread out of my mouth, and you didn't eat it." He said, "Well, what do you mean?" He turned around. He was eating a la mode, what is it, cantaloupe and ice cream. He had cantaloupe with a big scoop of vanilla ice cream in it. He said, "What did I do?" I said, "You took bread out of my mouth." He said, "Well, I," and I told him, I said that I was the one that had done crying in the chapel, and I revised it, I did it my way. He said, "Let me tell you about that." He said, "I didn't do it." He said, "I did this, I recorded this some time ago, and it was on the shelf, and the company was at liberty to release it whenever they got ready." He said, "So along came yours, and they saw that it was the time to release mine. They released it, but he went in his pocket, he got his checkbook, he wrote the numbers, folded up, and gave it to me. He said, 'Here, this should buy you some lunch.' And at the time, my pockets was full. I folded the check, put it in my purse, and kept it for 2 months or better. Till my funds ran out. Then one day I said, 'I don't see if this thing is any good.' And I took it, I went to the bank. When I got to the bank, I opened it up and I unfolded it. And the more zeros I saw on it, my heart started beating fast. I went to the telephone, I called my mama. I said, 'Mama, I got $10,000. She said, "What did you do to get it? No, I said, "Elvis Presley gave me that. But if I had known it was $10,000, it would have been cashed a long time ago." And then this happened to be around Christmas time. I came from a large, poor family. And I had little sisters and brothers who needed everything at Christmas time because my mama couldn't do it. I said, "Mama, I'm sending you some money." I said, "Make the children happy." She said, "You're coming home for Christmas." I said, "I don't know if I'll be home, but I'll be